I came to dance, 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 dance. I hit the floor cause that's my plans, 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 plans. I'm wearing all my favorite brands, 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 brands. Give me some space for both my hands, 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 hands. You, you, cause it goes on and on.
I'm Quinn and I'm here with Chris Koehl from So You Think You Can Dance. We just wanted to ask him a couple questions about professional life and spiritual life and everything like that. So Chris, thanks so much for being here. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for having me.
Good. We just wanted to maybe start off with like asking you a couple questions about your testimony and maybe how you became a Christian and how that started for you.
Okay. That's a big question. Okay, well, it's kind of a really long story because I was raised Christian since I was 5 years old. I remember, you know, saying the prayer, accepting Christ. But I don't know, I always felt like I didn't have that much of an interesting testimony. But it wasn't until later, really, when I was trying to get on So You Think You Can Dance and trying to pursue my career, that I realized the level of what I knew God was, in a way, almost kind of shallow. And I feel like that was the second half of my testimony that's far more interesting. I guess when you start graduating high school and you start looking at life and you start trying to figure out the direction you're going, you start asking more questions. And I was trying to do this dancing thing and I was going to college and, you know, I had God in my back pocket and I've known God for a long time. I'm not saying that I didn't know him growing up, but I just got to a point where I just got really lost. I didn't know really who I was as a dancer. And as I kept trying to pursue that in my career, I just felt like something was missing. And I auditioned for So You Think You Can Dance more than once. And the first time, I didn't make it. And the second time, I came really, really close. But I didn't feel like it was my dancing that was holding me back. I still felt like something was missing. And I spent the following year trying to figure out what is it in my dancing that's missing? And I began to realize it was a little bit of my identity in dance. Something with my identity was wrong. And it was a really interesting year for me because not only did I start trying to figure out who am I as a dancer, because I'm a hip hop dancer mostly, but that's just what I do. Like, some people are comedic with their dancing, some people are storytellers. Who am I? And when I addressed that, I started asking other big questions like, who am I in life? And what is my direction in life? You know, I believe in God. I've always believed in God, but what is that purpose? You know, sometimes we accept God, but we don't start asking him those bigger, scary questions. And as I did that, I began to know God on a much deeper level. And I feel like that's when my connection with God and my understanding of who I am and my purpose went to another level. And I feel like that's one of the main reasons that I made it on to the show. Because the next year when I went back and auditioned, I wasn't auditioning as a dancer who was just dancing to dance. I was auditioning with a purpose. And my purpose of who I found, who I am just in general, but as a dancer, is I'm passionate. I'm very passionate about what I do. I'm passionate about other people. And I don't want to just dance to have a good time. I realize that anything I do has a message behind it. And I want to move people through what I do.
So you're obviously an extremely talented dancer. We saw you on So You Think You Can Dance and you were really good. How did you even discover that talent? Was it someone that turned you on to it, or how did that come about?
Yeah, I've been working on it for a while. I started dancing around 14, but I remember, as far as trying to start that process, is actually kind of a funny story. I guess I was probably like 10. My mom and my sister were doing drill team kick line in the living room, and I was making fun of them. I had kind of this, I guess, little jock mindset of, oh, dancing's for girls, and it's so easy, anybody can do it, whatever, and I'm so cocky. It's terrible. I try not to be like that anymore. And so they're dancing, I'm like, I can do this, and I try to copy them, and I'm tripping all over the place. I'm literally almost falling to the ground trying to do, you know, grapevine bop ma, grapevine bop ma. And we laughed that night off going, yeah, Chris, stick with sports. Don't ever do dancing. And it's just funny because I think people think that, oh, in order to achieve being a dancer, you have to start when you're 3 years old, and you have to have had all this natural talent. And I didn't start until I was like 14, and I don't feel that I had a natural talent where I would move and everything just came out right. I had to work really, really hard for it. But I had, again, that passion behind it. And I feel like God really blessed that, and I feel like that was definitely the direction that He wanted me to go in.
On So You Think You Can Dance, when you were on that show, I saw that you had a ton of versatility. I saw that you did freestyle, you did Broadway, you did a ton of stuff. Do you have like sort of a favorite type of dance you like to do?
Favorite kind of dance? Well, I do mostly hip-hop. That's my genre, which I would definitely say that's my favorite. But at the same time, contemporary is a really close second. I wouldn't say that I'm as proficient in it, but it's just, there's so many cool stories that you can tell, and it brings just a different side of emotions, and it's beautiful. And I'd say those two, hip-hop and contemporary, most definitely.
Nice. So you're obviously in a very subjective and competitive industry. Do you have anything that you sort of draw inspiration and motivation from to get you through all that?
God.
Yeah, that's good.
God definitely is, he's my rock. He keeps me going. He keeps me refreshed. You can often just burn yourself to the ground from constantly grinding and trying to move forward, and you can just burn yourself out. So I feel like that's one way that I definitely refresh myself, but also just having a good solid group of people around you who know your moral compass and are on the same page with that, so that they don't pull you in the wrong direction when you are in the ruts.
So on So You Think You Can Dance, you did a lot of professional and live performances. Have there ever been any sort of funny or unexpected things happening to you during those performances?
Oh gosh. Yeah, I mean, we have all sorts of funny, good memories from that show. As far as like an embarrassing moment, probably the most embarrassing stage moment I had actually wasn't on So You Think, and I wasn't even on stage. I was volunteering. My sister was doing the Nutcracker, and there was the Swan Princess parts, like in the second half, where the ballet is this beautiful scenery, and towards the end they have the snow that begins to fall and trickle down. And so guess who was in charge of the snow? I'm over here on the side, and I'm pulling the pulley, and I'm shaking the snow up top so that it falls all over the stage. And the thing is it's this big bucket almost with little holes, and you kind of just, you're shaking it back and forth. I might have shook it a little too hard, and I mean, there's hundreds of pounds of paper, and I mean, it wasn't my fault. I mean, it was, but I was told to pull it more. I just didn't know how. I dumped the entire bucket on top of all of the whole core dancers and the lead ballerina. And it was really funny because the lead ballerina had like this huge pile that just hit her, and she was like, and her tutu flopped. And it wasn't really a light snow, it was more like a blizzard.
Oh, it was planned, it was fine.
Yeah, I was pretty embarrassed about it. But it was really funny. Everybody really enjoyed it because it was their senior year, and it was ending it with a big bang, literally.
Yeah. Now you have a good story out of it, so that's good.
Yeah.
So speaking of performances and things like that, do you have sort of a go-to dance move whenever anyone asks you?
Go-to dance move? The hokey pokey? No. I don't know. I'm a bit of a goofball. I don't know that I have like a go-to move. If I do, I don't know. I try to mix it up. Mm-hmm. I don't like to be like the, oh, look, he's doing the same thing over and over. I try to mix it up. But I mean, hokey pokey's not bad. That's a fun dance.
Yeah. So dancing obviously is one of your great passions, but do you have anything else that sort of plays an important role in your life?
Oh gosh, dance is the only thing I do. No, yeah, I think especially now that I'm out here in LA and I'm established as a professional dancer, I realize how important it is to be well-rounded, and that's something that my parents have always instilled in me. So I've done so many other sports, soccer and basketball and baseball. Just fun hobbies. I also really enjoy bike riding, like mountain bike riding. I used to go dirt bike riding as a kid. I did a lot of outdoorsy things, hiking. I don't know. I used to collect bugs. Is that weird? Is that weird? I was very much a boy. Yeah. I don't know.
That's cool. That's fun. Do you have any sort of upcoming plans, or what's next for you?
Ooh, gosh. The sky's the limit. So you thinking dance? I remember the second that I got, you know, ixnayed, cut off the show. It was kind of a down moment. But in that moment, as down as it was, because obviously I wanted to continue, I just sat back and I went, wow, what's next? I just got through living a dream. Like, that not many people can say that. And so for me, I've really spent since then trying to dream bigger. You know, for the longest time, I dreamed this much and assumed that that was, you know, I'm going to try to accomplish this, and I never really thought bigger than that. And I feel that when you think that small, it just doesn't leave you that many options. So I've been working on several projects. I'm doing acting now, or trying to. I'm trying to train. I've been doing dancing, trying to get into more of the choreography side. But I'm really enjoying the film side of it. I've done some stage work. So definitely just investigating the film side of the industry. I've done a few commercials. I've got one coming out soon I'm really excited about. Can't say anything till it's out. But one of the other things I'm working on is a Christian t-shirt company called TJC, Trust with Jesus Christ. And so that's something I jumped on board just with the advertisement side of that. What else am I doing? I got several little projects. Right now, I'm trying to kind of develop the full vision of it, but I'm working on putting together a nonprofit Christian ministry involving mostly dance, but as it grows and expands, I'd like it to involve acting and singing and all that. It would be media based through film. So I'm really excited about that. I feel like that's going to be a really big project that God is calling me to. It's a vision that will cause me to use all the skills that I've developed and be able to give to God in a new way, and involve so many other people who have all this talent, but in this industry aren't always able to glorify God through it and tell stories that really truly matter. And this is just going to be a great opportunity to do that. So it's something I'm working on this year. I probably won't get anything out until next year, but yeah, I'm just crossing my fingers and praying to God, trying to get the full vision of this Christian ministry.
Well, that all sounds great. It sounds like you're definitely keeping busy. So do you have any sort of spiritual or professional advice for our readers at Unleash Beauty?
I think the best advice that I could give to girls out there, don't buy into the idea of chasing after a guy. That you have to always dull yourself up, that you have to buy all this stuff, that you have to do any chasing, or that you should even be chased, I think is the biggest thing. That there are guys out there who are willing to wait, who are willing to treat you right, who are willing to put God first in your relationship. There's so many people that I've found and I go, wow, I admire the way your relationship is with your girlfriend or your soon-to-be wife. And I feel that, especially in the dance industry, so many girls who think that they have to sell themselves short. And I just really, really, really am passionate about letting you know that you don't have to do that, that there are genuine, passionate guys who will care for you and love you the right way. Don't go looking for them. Let God bring them to you. Focus on the things that matter, school, work, that sort of thing.
So thank you so much, Chris, for being here today. We all really appreciate it, and we just wish you well in the future.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Thank you for listening.